Hey Heart Youth, thank you so much for joining with us online tonight for our weekend experience. We believe that God wants to do something in you, which is why church is not stopping. We believe that quarantine shouldn't be done alone, so as you're locked down, as you're hanging out in your homes, we want to make sure you feel like you're not alone in this season. So tonight we have a special service planned for you. I want to encourage you, man, pull out a notepad, take notes during the message, find a place to be alone in your home, find a corner, find a closet, wherever you need to go to get alone and spend a couple moments with God. Enjoy tonight's service. We love you guys.
And it's heavenly. the table with the King. And it's the real thing.
Man, these last couple weeks we've had the incredible opportunity to do guided prayers. Now we've been praying through certain topics, and in this season we know that God is near, and that when we pray, He hears us and He wants to answer our prayers, and His heart is for healing during this time. And so we had a really cool story come from a Zoom call that we were on this last week. So Pastor Chris is going to share a really cool story, so lean in.
Yeah, so we've been doing Zoom calls with local youth pastors, and last week we had 30 youth pastors on the Zoom call. I reached out to a guy about getting on. He's part of our community. He brought his students to Valley Conference. He's family to Heart Youth. And so we asked him if he'd jump on the call, and he said he wasn't able to make it because his mother was in the final stages of the coronavirus. And it wasn't in the final stages as in she was going to get better, but he was planning on getting her life together, getting a will together, because it looked like she was going to pass. And as a community of youth pastors, we prayed for her. And then he sent me this text the other day. He said, "My mother was taken off the ventilator yesterday. After a miraculous turnaround, she went from needing the vent to breathe and things looking pretty grim, now to only needing very little breathing support, mostly for her asthma. She has been upgraded from ICU into a regular room in stable condition. Thank you for your prayers. We believe prayer works, and we know God hears us when we pray." Yeah. So Ryan, kind of tell us a little bit how we're doing guided prayer this week.
Yeah, so tonight, rather than lifting up topics, what we want to do is we want to pray for your prayer requests. So the chat is completely open. Anything that you can need prayer for, something you're walking through, something your family's walking through, we want to lift you up. And so we're going to encourage you, take some time, drop a prayer request. We're going to be praying for you guys. Also, if you don't have a prayer request, take this time, look at someone else's comment, and lift them up in prayer. We believe that prayer works, and God is as near as the mention of His name. And so tonight, let's call down heaven, and let's lift up these prayer requests.
Father, we thank you for every
request that was made known. God, we thank you that you are near to us, and God, that you are faithful. And Jesus, we believe you are able to do miraculous things, as we've already seen. We know you've done it for someone else. We believe you can do it for us. God, we pray for those who have, whose families have lost jobs, students who feel lonely and depressed, students who just are just trying to find their way. God, I pray that you would meet us powerfully in this season. God, you're near, and I pray that you move in our hearts and our lives. I pray this in Jesus' name. And everyone commented,
amen.
Have you ever felt weighed down? Unsure of your future? Like you just don't have what it takes for tomorrow? Like the thoughts you have move faster than you can make sense of? Like you're drowning in your doubt, scrolling for hours and not finding what your eyes are really searching for? Man, there is nothing worse than being stuck in your head with anxious thoughts and worry. Proverbs 12:25 says, "An anxious heart weighs people down." During this time, this unprecedented, this unexpected and different time in our generation, you may feel weighed down by your worry and by your anxiety. We feel weighed down because worry is really just a vicious cycle. It keeps you spinning in your thoughts, stuck in your head. We scroll and then refresh. We binge and then search for something new. We turn on whatever is around us to turn off the way that life is making us feel. We worry, so we scroll, we swipe, we click, we search for anything to feel some type of way. Worry, we've ingested it so much, it's like we're immune to not even knowing what peace tastes like anymore. You know, it's a dangerous place to be, in a spot where what God said doesn't line up with our situation. It seems that worry has plagued us more than a pandemic ever could. So what are you worried about? If I'm being honest, I've always dealt with worry and I've always struggled with having anxious thoughts. But I remember there was this one moment in my life that marked me forever, and I have never been more afraid. It was my freshman year of college during spring break. Me and some buddies, we went down to Tampa, Florida to hang out on the beach and go to Disney. And one day we found ourselves at a theme park called Busch Gardens. I don't know if you're like me, but I love theme parks. Like, I'm always down for the food. But even more than the food, I love the rides. I have never wussed out on going on a roller coaster ride. I love the feeling of the drop. I love the thrill. I love the scream. I love everything about it. And I remember at this park specifically, there was this ride that we went on, and it was called Falcon's Fury. Now, what you need to know about Falcon's Fury is that it's actually the tallest freestanding drop tower in North America. The ride seats you around a pole and you go all the way up 335 feet into the air, and your chair begins to face the ground, and then you free fall for 300 feet. Literally the craziest ride that I have ever been on. I remember looking at the tower, looking at my friends and being like, yo, let's go. Let's take this thing on. I was feeling myself. I was feeling good. As we got closer to the beginning of the line, I was seeing people's reactions and how scared and fearful people were. And I began to kind of have second doubts a little bit, like, man, I don't know if I'm equipped for this. Like, okay, but let's just go for it. I remember as I was getting strapped in, I asked one of the guys that worked there, I said, hey, what are some tips? Like, what should I be doing? How can I like survive? Am I gonna make it? Like, am I good? He's like, man, you'll be good. Just look up. I remember as the ride started, it was making some creaky noises. I was a little bit freaked out, and slowly but surely we began to climb up the tower, up 50 feet, 100 feet, 200 feet, 250 feet, 300 feet. And I began to freak out. Now, I don't know if you've done this on a roller coaster, but as we got to the top, it's like my whole life turned into slow motion. I began to think of all the things that I had done wrong in my life, replaying scenarios, starting to write my will for my future kids that I probably wouldn't even have. I remember I was so terrified. And at the very top, I remember I did something that was so wrong. I looked down. Now, if you've ever been on a roller coaster like this, you know the number one rule is you don't look down. I remember I looked down and people were like invisible. I couldn't even see people anymore. Buildings that used to be huge looked like specks. And I remember I was so overcome with fear. I was literally freaking out. And I'm not exaggerating to you. I have never been more afraid. It was in that moment that the guy's words flooded back into my mind of just look up. Look up. It's wild to think that in the greatest sermon that was ever preached, Jesus stood on a mount and spoke to the heart of every human that would walk with worry. And the first word that left his mouth was, look. Matthew 6, 23, Jesus says, look at the birds. Now, I wouldn't consider myself a bird watcher or anything weird like that, but I know where to look to see a bird, and it's in the sky. Look at the birds. See, maybe the reason I'm worried the way that I'm worried, maybe the reason quarantine is making me more anxious, maybe the reason why the state of my soul feels off isn't because God is distant, but it's because of where I'm looking. It's not that things aren't going on in my life. It's not living in denial of reality. It's that I know where to look. Look up. See, don't let isolation take your eyes, for even in a pandemic, there's purpose. Look up, for there is a God who is above you, who has gone before you, and who lives within you and is forever for you. Look at the birds. Jesus continues and says, they don't plant or harvest or store food in barns, for your heavenly Father feeds them. And aren't you more valuable to him than they are? If God gives such attention to the appearance of wildflowers, don't you think he'll attend to you, take pride in you, do his best for you? God will help you deal with whatever hard things come up when the time comes. See, the God who's got the birds has got you. So in everything, we hold fast to the one who is in control, in canceled events, in broken homes, in the loss of graduations, in layoffs, in pay cuts, in panic attack, in uncertainty, in the depths of depression, in loss, in quarantine, in my life. I will look to the one who holds my future. Worrying won't work for me anymore. And in the place where worry used to take me, is the place that now I've seen God's hand work. So what are you worried about right now? Like actually, why do you worry? Can all your worries add a single moment to your life? Don't toss and turn over something that you can't control, because if your faith is in Jesus, worry is worthless. Do not worry, for he is with you, and because he's with you, worry won't work for us anymore.
Hey guys, what's going on? Hope you're doing good. Thanks for watching online tonight.
It was incredible.
And we can't
wait
for you
to join us
on Zoom.
The ID code is?
I don't know the ID code.
In the comments down below.
Make sure you hop on.
And
don't do
anything
alone.
Because God
loves
you
so much
that
he
gave
his
only
son.
So
get on Zoom.
We love you guys.
Love you.
Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe.